But without further ado, let's jump into core. Trying to remember what we were doing. So, the problem I was, the thing I was having like the most trouble with was that. So, I just really struggled trying to like get the height and the jump over that first set of spikes. If I can find a consistent way to do it, then we should be alright. It's just finding that consistency. And then obviously dashing at the right times as well. Left off on Friday. Ah, did the diagonal right. I did diagonal right there, but I don't want to diagonal right on my first dash. I really need to get like a less flimsy pop filter. Can't get the right height off this side, which is the frustrating thing. And then I don't get enough height to go over the other side. Maybe I'm just holding jump for too long. Yeah, I think that's what it is. Or not long enough, as the case may be. And I'm back to the same problem I had on Friday, where I just don't seem, for some reason, I don't seem to be able to get the height off that right-hand side platform off the conveyor belt. I don't know why. And then I went too early in the second dash. It's quite frustrating because you know when you make a mistake, you know, like the moment you press the button on the key on like the pad, it's like, yep, that's not gonna work. I knew with that second dash, I went like half a second too early. I'm just really annoyed that I can't get a consistent height on that jump. Why I lost the dash there. I should have got it back. Just trying to practice like some jumping. Then of course, once I actually do it in a live environment, it all goes wrong. Yeah, what's going on, Smeltry? Yeah, I've had it on a few of my streams for this. I think it's really nice, a really nice touch. So so that when I'm moaning and bitching about I didn't press that button, everybody can say, actually, Nock, you did. It's not really helping, though, to be fair. Why was I flashing red? I was flashing red because I grab onto these conveyor belts and I'm running out of stamina. So when it flashes red, basically, I don't know where to go from here. When I flash red and I run out of stamina, it means because I'm grabbing onto something, I'm basically going to die. If I don't either replenish my stamina by getting a green crystal heart or touching the floor. So, yeah. You only have a certain amount of grabbing capabilities. Ah, man. All right, so basically the blue heart, the heart switches on the core level, basically swap between fire and ice. So, obviously, blue is ice, red is fire. Pretty self-explanatory. But yeah, when you change from fire to ice, it actually changes the dynamics of the level. As you can see, like with the fire, we get these conveyor belts on the side, whereas with the ice, they're just slippery edge faces that we couldn't grab onto. If they were normal walls, you could like grab onto them and climb up them, but because they're ice, you cannot. But yeah. What can I say? I just want to make sure everyone knows what I'm talking about. I'm jumping too far to the right. I do know that there are actually 8 seasides iron smeltery. I ain't getting no seasides unless I pass this level first. My problem was, when I got to like the third conveyor, I kind of hesitated because I don't know which directions and which like where to grab and stuff. And that's kind of like thrown me off a bit. I should have maybe just gone for it and... No, I pretty much know everything that's in the game, I'll say. I don't know. Obviously, I don't know how to solve the levels. I didn't diagonal dash. Which is why we've been struggling on this chord now for nigh on 2.5 hours. This particular room for well over an hour. I've just been having like my main trouble has been with like these conveyors. The when I'm growing on these smaller ones. When I look grab on the smaller ones, I just don't seem to be able to like get the right amount of height for some reason. That's where I've been struggling a lot of the time on this room. Knockered. Should be nice to have a change of scenery now. Spending so much time on this. Alright, so I do just want to check real quickly. I want to check the movement, like, later on. Done this room. Right, this room. Okay. So it jumps over the spikes. Right diagonal, and then a right. Simple, right? Simple. See what time it is, buddy. If it's too late, I'll probably just head to bed. Depends how long I'm playing around with this. Deathwish might be knocking about though, if you want to maybe hit Deathwish up, see if he's up for a game. Don't know if Sadiq's about as well. Oh, okay. Gonna be not be able to get over this freaking thing again now, am I? I'm always watching. Stalker. I think I've worked this out now, actually. I know I just failed it on there, but I think the key is to let go really early on there. Don't ride the conveyor to the top. I went all the way back to get my dash and then still messed it up. Good job, Nock. 10 out of 10. When I say I've got it, Iron Smeltery, I mean, I know in my head the sequence of button presses that needs to occur and where those button presses need to occur. Doesn't mean that I'm going to do it first time, trust me. There's still quite a lot of precision involved. Alright, so it's getting over that final ledge. If I get over that final ledge, then I believe I'm in with a chance. Not like that, though. Oh yes! We're through the room, boys. Celebrate! Oh my goodness. Now I just need to deal with the juggling fireballs. I guess what I gotta do, I think I gotta slot down in there. Yeah, I don't think I'm going to be able to get across the bottom and do this, am I? How How am I doing this? Right, that would buy me some time. If I can time this right. Then I have to go pretty much straight away. How else can I get across this room? I've got to hit that conveyor, but it's about timing it right. Obviously. Climbing into the ceiling will not help. I ran out of stamina. If I can time that jump from like that, can go from one conveyor to the other, I might stand a chance. I kind of feel though, like without a dash, I'm not going to make it. So don't think I'm going to get enough momentum from the conveyor alone. Don't know, I might do. That's what I need to do. Alright. Progress was made. Thank you. I didn't think I was going to get the freaking stamina crystal. Roof movement here is like so minor. What's going on, Eddie? How you doing today, buddy? How was your weekend? Now I can't get in there. I can't get into the freaking thing. So close. Messed up my inputs completely there. Come on. Can you find blue? That's all I gotta do. Terrible. My strats are good enough for like place number 802 in the 100% in the any percent speedrun. That's about all my, that's about as good as my strats come. That's about all they're good for. Just not sure how I'm meant to do that last one. Oh man. If I had turned to the left there, I would have grabbed the wall and I would have avoided that death. Jump too early. So I meant to dash there? I'm forgetting my strats now. Yeah, I think I was meant to dash there, wasn't I? I just don't... I need to try and think about what I can do differently on that last platform. I definitely need a dash there, though. I don't think I'm going to have enough to get across there if I don't have a dash. So that would mean... So I've got to save a dash. That means I've got to go from the crystal. From the crystal, I've got to get on to the other conveyor. But it's, I don't know how to avoid the fireballs. That's the main issue here. Maybe instead of diagonal up dashing, I should try doing a diagonal down dash. Perhaps. Or maybe the diagonal's not the right thing to do at all. Maybe I just do a right dash. Too low on there. I've got to stay quite high on that conveyor, else I'm too low and then I get hit by the fireball. Yeah, doing a right dash is going to get me caught there. That was it, but I didn't get high off the conveyor. I do believe I actually did the diagonal, so diagonal is the right move to do. I need to just get on that platform. Above the fireball. totally forgot the strategy there. Why did I jump off the top there? If I'd only gone lower. Oh, it went too... I went marginally too quick on the jump. No, I can't get onto it again. Why did I jump off there? Dash was way out of where it was meant to be. It's terrible. Dashed off there. I don't know why. This game, I swear downright, this game is designed to do one thing, and that's to turn your brain into mush and confuse the hell out of you. In that you try everything so many times that you just kind of forget what you're doing halfway through, to add to the confusion of everything. Oh, it's not fair. I'm gonna tell my mummy. The game's not being fair. Thank you. Again, they're there. My brain just went to mush. I just totally forget the strategies halfway through. I'm like, I was meant to do what? Looking for some inspiration though. I need some inspirational quotes. Eddie, I'm looking at you. Hit me up with some inspiration, my man. No worries, we made it. Whew. Oh dear. I'll save that to my bookmarks, Eddie. I'll take a look later. Okay. This is just purely timing. Hey, we found the blue. Did we win? Infinite steals? You can steal? In worms? I've never used steel ever. Thank you. Oh my goodness, can I please get through here? It annoys me more that I fluked it the other time, and now I can't replicate. Mushy brain syndrome. Again. Totally the wrong way. Oh! What did I do that for? Seriously. Oh, I have to freaking use the thing. Alright. Alright. Something about snakes and eggs. Not sure how I fluked that, but I did. How could I forget about the lizard snakehead extra, Eddie? I'm glad you reminded me about that, you know. It's just what I was looking for. Thank you. and no stamina left to do the next part. One, two, three, diagonal dashes, then a right dash, then a diagonal dash. Then we should hit the switch. Is it three diagonal dashes for Nock? Depends how long I leave. Oh man. Where I'm hitting this button three times, but I'm only getting two dashes. And I'm not getting an upwards. Oh, not sure how I saved that, but I did. The only bit I'm not sure of is like how to optimally get the crystal when I'm bouncing on the frozen fireballs. Thank you. Maybe I just missed the top one. Maybe. Close. I just went for like a speed through that and it just seemed to work, but chances are I won't be able to replicate it. Oh, and I missed it. Alright. As I've said, there are many points before in this playthrough, it seems going faster is better. It seems the more time you like sit around and think about things, the more prone you are to errors. So close. Missed the crystal. Just getting too confident now. That was way out of time. Way out of position. Alright, Eddie, no worries. Thanks for stopping by, buddy. You have a good rest of the evening. Mind went again there. You're making a landscape to go with it. In there. Fractionally too early. And I totally forgot what I was meant to do there. Jump into the dash. Can't hit that one right. I can't hit it in a position where I can get onto one of the frozen fireballs. did it. All right. Oh my goodness. This is good though, we're on the like the next section of them. Oh yes, one of these iron smeltery. I can see what I need to do. I just need to get the right freaking height. There we go. But I need to bounce onto the other side. This is a good sign though, because being here means I'm now over halfway through this level in total. So I'm sure I'm only halfway. All right, so to sort of give you an idea. So, we've done this. So we've done 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So we are now in here. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 more screens to go. So we've got 4 of these vertical screens. Followed by 4 horizontals and then the last one. So if we're lucky, we may get to the end tonight. If not, maybe tomorrow. And then seaside, yes. And now, obviously, I know that the seasides are insanely difficult, but the seasides as well are relatively short, as in there's not many screens, so. From my. From my knowledge and understanding of the game, a lot of people tend to say that seasides are generally easier because of they're shorter. That's not golden strawberries, though, is it? That can't be golden strawberries as well, surely. Just to 100%, I would say. Guess what? Golden strawberries included? That's pretty freaking impressive, my man. Oh my absolute god. I need to pick my path through there. That's pretty impressive though, I'll be honest. In a week, props to your friend. I'm going to say your friend had an advantage though because he's Canadian, it's a Canadian game. Oh man. This is where you tell me your friend is actually Matt Makes Games. Alright, that's not too bad. So I've got to use both pinballs. Can I please stop hitting that freaking ice block right? It's the same one every time. Jeez. Oh, so close. So what I don't understand though about this, like the logic of this room, is how can ice rise? I get that the lava's rising, but ice? Seriously? Nailed it. Oh my god. Is this even possible? God. Well, this room isn't a trolley room, is it? You made a second map? Alright, maybe I go quicker again. Maybe, again, going quicker is the best thing to do here. If I just get my directions on point, that's going to happen. That felt like it was too early. But sir, I think you just answered your own question. I was on vacation that day. What are you doing? Playing Venture Capitalist or something? Why did I go there? It's driving me crazy because it's just a matter of timing. And I just can't get the timing down at all. There's nothing else to it. It's pure and simple. Timing. In the what now galaxy? Man, I get lost with space talk. Last time I went to space, I was taken captive by some space aliens, and they made me build factories, and it wasn't a happy time. Will you secretly work for NASA or something? Oh, you cock! Sorry, but... Other genitalia is available. Disclaimer. Oh, I Feel like I'm getting close though now. I just need to... That dash there. I need to be a bit quicker with that dash. Shouldn't have gone. Shouldn't have gone. You are kidding. Ah, that's a shame. He'll be on the VOD. Mr. Crystal! The game's just trolling me now. It's like, so you have this worked out, do you? Let's throw you a curveball. Wasn't paying attention there. Yes! Oh, shite. This is like the last of the vertical screens, though, so. Of course, a mechanic from each of the previous sections. Ah! Oh, you. What was what? What was what? Alright, final four screens before we get to the Crystal Heart screen. You thought that was crazy? Shit is about to go even crazier. Good on, Money Pinnicky. How you doing, buddy? Who's there? This will be even cooler if I can get through these next four screens. It's the final four B-side screens. Come on. We need some hype in the chat. It's the final countdown. Ba-da-ba-ba-bum. Ba-da-ba-bum. Ba-ba-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum. How? 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 I can't to get to over across to the bumpers. I've got to use the dash to hit the switch to switch it to ice. Oh no, there we go. Okay, well that certainly helps. Seems like you coming in, you saying that has actually like given me more momentum for some reason. I don't know how. But now I can't replicate it. Oh, actually. Okay. Jeez, that's hard. It's not something I can like easily replicate, which is... Alright, I should have waited a bit there. Oh, the puns. So punny. You're all so punny. Actually, I think I get a better... Oh my god. I think I get more momentum if I don't jump off the block. Nope, I have to jump off the block. I think... He's got Nock, dude. Be a lot easier though if I could like get over there without having to rely on the momentum to I can't even get on this first freaking block now. No! Alright, but in positive news, I think I've mastered that first jump now. Whew! Alright, he is playing ball, you are correct. Oh, jeez. I forgot about that. Oh, you... All right, well, at least this screen's not too big. Thank you. I see you, Money Panicky. Looking for your 5 minutes of fame. Oh, I can't. Connection was lost? No, it wasn't. What you talking about? Say hello to Twitch for you. Hello, Twitch for you. I think I've got to be quicker, so when I get to like the final bit, the lava's like pretty high up. If it's too low, then I'm screwed. Can't get my jump off here. Come on. And I didn't hit the frickin'. All right, that's an option. I can jump out and jump back in again, maybe. That's not good, though. I jumped off that and got extra height, and it threw me off. Can't hit the fifth one. I'm not getting my height. Because I'm jumping far too early. It's all about the timing. I'm going to try and hang it out a little bit before I touch the switch to switch it back to ice. That's what I want to do. Oh, and I missed it. I don't know what else to do if this isn't the right thing though. Thank you. I'm doing it again. Do you know what? That's a fantastic hint. Although, the game tells you it's good to die. So, oh, Geeks Playing Baba is you. I've heard good things about that game. Honestly and truthfully, I just don't think I'm getting what I'm meant to be doing in this room. And my gut feeling is, even though I don't think this will ever work. Because my instinct's telling me I need to be quicker, but I can't be any quicker. He says. Oh, you gotta love it. This one doesn't feel as frustrating as the last, which is good. Of course, I just need to land on that ledge, which would be very helpful indeed. There we go. I also need to dash underneath that ledge there. What's going on, Pia? How you doing, buddy? Welcome along to the stream. As you can see, we are tantalizingly close to the end of Core B. Finally. Oh man, I think, oh, okay, I gotta grab that other ledge. I think. Good to hear, buddy. Good to hear. Course, can't go back onto the ledge. I was thinking I'd go back onto the ledge to get some momentum to fly over there, but no, not going to work because we're on ice, not fire. I didn't mean to touch the one at the top straight away. Grab onto there. I didn't grab onto the ledge. My thumb is starting to get tired again, though. All right. I think this is the last screen before the crystal heart screen now. Oh, man. I gotta save my dash. Maybe I gotta save my dash. Yeah, okay. Yes, it is. And it's probably gonna be my only time through 8B. The way this has been going. But I can't give up now. I refuse to quit tonight until this is done. Oh, why did I do that for? Because I have previously looked at how many screens there were on Core B, and I'm pretty sure after the vertical section there were 4 screens. There were 4 screens horizontally before you get to the crystal screen. Also, I have watched TGH's 100% speedrun. Sorry, 114% speedrun that he did. So I have seen some of the screens and I recognize some of the screens, so. Yes, 114%. I'm only going for 100 though. On stream at least. No, I can't tell, I can't remember what the Riven Trial is, if I'm honest. Although I've seen it being played, I don't have any recollection, because at the end of the day, that speedrun was 8 hours long. So, and I was watching at double speed. Top block, and then I got to do a diagonal out across. I didn't get any momentum off that. Hopefully. I'm not jumping off the block. I'm changing direction, but I'm not getting the... I'm not jumping off the block. So I'm not getting any momentum across to the other side. It's going to be close, actually, on the on my summit time at this rate. I'm not quite sure how I hit the diagonal there, but clearly I did. First two B-sides, every section is 5 rooms. Oh, I wasn't prepared for it! It's always the way. I think this one's mainly been 4, is that right? 4 on, mainly on this one? I'm convinced I'm not pushing up. I wasn't! I guess it was just the momentum from the... I guess it was a momentum from the block. Too late. That was the closest I've been. don't think I dashed up. I just did a... I didn't do a diagonal up. A diagonal right. I just went right. Either that or I dashed momentarily too early. Do you want me to hand you the controller, Iron Smeltry? Oh, I didn't jump off the block. There's nothing I would love more than to just freaking do it, man. Trust me. Summit B was 450. I feel like I held back. It's gonna be close. At the minute, I would say I'm going to get a... It's going to be a longer time. I need to get closer to the center of that block. The button for no clip. Oh dear. Hashtag this ain't no portal 2. Oh. Yeah. I'm pretty sure I agree. Oh, you're kidding. I was about a quarter of a second off. Too slow pressing dash there. That's why I hit the lava. Come on, Nock. No. God, no. How much... I mean, I've not used it myself, but what does the assist mode actually do in the game? Oh, yes. Oh my goodness. Anti-gravity? Oh my goodness. Okay. That's sneaky, but I really like this. This is really clever. I don't mind being stuck on this for like half an hour. This is quite fun. I'm enjoying this. Worms ain't gonna happen tonight, man. It's getting too late for me. I'm afraid. No! Tried to do too much. And again, I tried to do too much. I'll read that in a minute, Peter. Gives you certain options you could toggle, allows you to play at 90, 80, 70, 60, and 50% speed. Toggle invisibility gives yourself double dash early or just infinity dash. There are one or two other options. Wow. That's Oh, hang on, a dash. I need a dash to get through there. Still earn achievements and everything with assist mode? Because that seems a little... Like, can you do, like, gold strawberries with assist mode? Surely that would, like, give such an unfair advantage. anybody using assist mode? Oh, you turd. Yeah, I would agree. I would agree. We're 5 minutes quicker than Summit B-side. Whew. I am going to grab that as a screenshot for the thumbnail of this video. Yeah, but I don't know. I mean, granted, I'm not the best player, and I plan on learning and improving my skill set, definitely. But I think the game does a really fantastic job of actually teaching you anyway of how to play the game and how to get better at the game. But hey, everybody's free to play the game however they want. For me personally, I wouldn't. Ready for a real challenge. Seasides have been unlocked and golden strawberries have appeared at the start of every chapter. Good luck, Madeline. 2200 on the dot. Holy jeez. Well, that's it, guys. We have got to the end of our B-sides. Let's finish off. Because I'm pretty sure I can get through here without dying. We'll look at Corsi. He says, I was about to say that's probably about the only place where I will die. Second screen, course C. I can't because I haven't got enough hearts. There ain't no looking at course C until I've got all the hearts. Alright, but I'm going to end up... I'm going to try and finish off doing... Forsaken City Deathless. I have already done it on file as well, which is... Before I got the... Oh, the heartlock. Oh man, come on. Thank you. There we go, much better. Such like light relief playing the regular levels after playing B-sides for so long. Man. Uh-oh. No! I have tried to do it dashless. I struggle, and I'll show you which screen I struggle on, and I can't get past at the minute. So I can get past this one dashless. This one I can't. I can't do the thing right to get over them spikes on that top wall. Oh! No, I can do the screen with the gem. That's not an issue. It takes me a few attempts to get over there, but... I can do the one with the gem. It's the second screen on the middle section of the level. Oh, man. Yeah, I can do this one. This one's not a problem. I say, it takes me a few attempts, but... Because you got to climb the wall, haven't you? And you got to like press dash, like dash off the spikes, and that's what I struggle with. Yeah, I tried. I've also tried adding a macro onto my on the DS4 to kind of like spam the jump button, but I'm still having trouble with it. How did I not grab that strawberry? Alright, you know what? I'm going to leave that. But I will do some golden strawberries on A-sides, definitely. B's and C's, forget it. Tomorrow night, though, guys, we will be starting on C-sides. Yes, the final 8 golden hearts. We will be... just a jump. I've also tried like bind and jump to two different buttons and like pressing them like almost at the same time, but I'll keep practicing because practice makes perfect. Thank you very much, everybody, for tuning in. We'll be back tomorrow, like I said, with some seaside, starting off the seasides on the final eight hearts, the slog. Thank you very much, everybody, for tuning in. Thank you for sticking with it. Thank you for the support and the words of encouragement. I really, really appreciate it. But until tomorrow, guys, I've been Nock. You've been awesome. See ya.